Hey everybody, it's Mike here from The Art of Guitar. Last night I was practicing on the couch and I had my laptop open in front of me and it started to autoplay a video of a song that I'd never heard before, but I couldn't hear the audio. So I was practicing and I was thinking, you know, it's kind of fun to just watch the video and try to imagine what the music sounds like. So I thought this might be a really fun exercise, experiment, whatever you want to call it. So today I came in and I searched for a 90s alternative video. I just thought that would be a good place to start for this kind of exercise. And it was hard for me to find one that I've never heard before. But I ran into this video by a band called Loud Lucy. And the song is called Ticking. And so I made sure that my volume was all the way down. And I played through it and I just watched the band play a little bit. And I thought, you know what? This would be kind of fun because I can play drums, bass, and guitar to try to decipher as well as I can what they're doing without having ever heard the song. So what I'm gonna do today is I'm gonna walk you through quickly my process, and then I'm just gonna play what I came up with. It's only about 30 seconds of the video. And then I'm gonna actually play the real music for the first time and hear it for the first time in front of you so you can see if I got close at all and my reaction and all that good stuff. So let's get started. Okay, right there. I thought it'd be a good place to start. It seems like it's an instrumental breakdown. No vocals going on. Watching the drummer, it looks like he's doing kind of a Smells Like Teen Spirit type beat. Some drum fills right there. The guitar player and the bass player are kind of doing this with their arms so I can kind of feel the tempo, feel how it's gonna feel, hopefully. This is so 90s. By the way, this song came out in 95. Okay, so the drummer's on the ride cymbal for the most part. The guitar player is doing some power chord stuff, hitting the guitar really hard, and then he's coming up and doing some octave stuff up high, it looks like. So after watching the drummer all those times, this is what I came up with for an outline for the drum track. The guitar player was a little bit more deceiving to me because they were cutting to different shots of him and he was always kind of freaking out and sometimes it was hard to see exactly what he was doing. But the beginning starts off with what looks like three distinct hits and I just pictured the drummer hitting with him. So right here you're gonna see bam, bam, bam. And then his fingers go right up to the D chord it looks like. So I ended up making this for the guitar part. So I kind of went with like a Smashing Pumpkins Bush kind of tone for the guitar and ended up with this sound. Now there's one part where I noticed his fingers were doing this big spread pull-off type thing. So I just guessed that he's going like this. It's a very Billy Corgan move, isn't it? Back to that part. Then once again, the crazy pull-offs. Now this is the part that gets interesting to me. There's some hits and you could definitely tell that they're all hitting together for a certain spot. Then if you watch his hands, they move up high. So because I'm thinking of the time that it was made, 1995, I'm guessing it sounds like this. I just put that little slide there. I don't think he really does that in the video, but I'm just guessing it's in there. And then the end is kind of deceiving because he does some weird thing with his hand. I'm not sure. It looks like some kind of half open chord. So I just guessed it went like this. And then the chorus either goes, I don't know, into the F or the C. Both sound good. So I just went with the F. Okay, so here's the video with my audio over the top of it. Let's check it out. Okay, and now let's do the big reveal. I'm gonna play it here on my laptop and hear it for the very first time, and let's see what happens. Oh, he's a arpeggiator. Damn it, I was wrong about the next chord. I guessed F. Like I said earlier, it could be C. They went to C. Okay, a couple things that I was way off on. I didn't know he was doing kind of a guitar solo over the top of it. If you just watch the video, he's not really doing, besides that little pull-off thing, a solo-y type thing, like with his hands. So that confused me. I did not know there was soloing going on. Also, he was doing sort of an arpeggiated sound when he went to the D chord, whereas I was just going all out chords. So that was a big difference there too. But one thing that I was really excited about was when they did the G to the high stuff, there was a point where they did, I think it was power chords, but they did a half step slide downward. So they did something like. But I did octaves, I believe they did power chords. I'll have to listen to it again later. Okay, that was a fun experiment. I think I'm gonna try this for other styles of music, you know, like starting off with 90s alternative is kind of narrowing down the possibilities a lot, just because there was a specific sound at the time. But maybe in the future I'll do something by, you know, a band like Dragon Force or Dream Theater, or I don't know, maybe a new Megadeth song or something that I haven't heard yet. Okay, everyone, thanks for watching my experiment. And if you have any suggestions for the next video, let me know. All right, catch you later. Bye-bye.